This is Nita Gray, one of the handful of women who have become lady auctioneers. Last year, she quit her 18-year position in the medical profession and entered the Missouri Auction School. She said she just wanted to change her life, and from the sound of things, she has.
What really excites you about being an auctioneer?
Well, you have this item out here in front of you, and you're in control of it. And if you can get so much money out of that, I mean, I like to work that crowd. I like to pull all I can for that piece. It just fascinates me with how much money I can get for that piece. Actually, how much I can get for that.
All auctioneers are bestowed with the honorary title of Colonel, and Nita is no exception. As Colonel Gray, she has auctioned off everything from auto parts to expensive art pieces. But on Tuesday nights, you can find her at Deb's Antiques, where she works the crowd to her satisfaction.
55 over there.
Is being fast the most important thing?
No, it's not. It's how you pronounce your words. If you're at $20, then say $20. Now, I had a tendency to go a little fast when I first started. Everybody does, I think. There's a rhythm that they teach you, and it goes, it'll go like 10, 10, 10, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20.
That rhythm didn't always come easy for Nita. For two extensive weeks, she and her classmates spent 9 hours a day, every day, continuously chanting to the incantations of their instructor. And back at Deb's, Nita convinced me it might be fun to give it a try myself. After all, it didn't really look that hard. So after limbering up with some Betty Barter tongue twisters, I tried my hand at auctioneering.
$150.
Will you bid to buy 50? Will you give me 50?
Okay.
Well, I discovered auctioneering certainly was fun, but best left to Nita. And even though she is now a successful auctioneer, you'll still find her practicing 2 to 5 hours a day, perfecting her chant.
I practice at home, you know, all the time. I'm constantly singing this little song, I'm doing my little chant, you know, while I'm cooking, while I'm showering, you know, doing the lawn. The lampposts, I probably have sold every lamppost in Los Angeles. They're my bidders. When I'm driving down the street and I've got a $5 bid here, well, then I'll chant till I get to the next light pole, and then I sell it. Cars are the same way. I'll pick a car. As they're going past me, I'll pick a red car, a yellow car, and I chant all the way down 20, 30, 40, now 50, will you give me 50? That car gets to me, I've sold it to you, sir, for $50.
While Nita was out rehearsing with light poles, I asked her husband, Rex, what it was like around the house while she practiced.
Total insanity. I can't watch my football games, you know, because I'm bidding all the time.
Well, you could just yell, sold. And that's it. She'd have to stop. But
then she brings up something else. I never wind.
And indeed, Rex was right. Even at their local supermarket, Nita auctions off produce, meats, and cheeses while using Rex to up the ante.
How about some steaks? You want a steak? Or do you want the whole cow? I'll tell you what, I'll sell you the whole cow for $500 bill on it. Give me a $500 bill on it? My ultimate goal, I think, is to be, mind you, I realize I have a ways to grow, but I'd really like to be recognized as the Dolly Parton of auctioneering.
Oh, they're playing my song. Oh, yeah, they're playing my song. And when they're playing my song, everybody's got a magic of words is weaving its spell around this room. Nobody's dancing, they're all too entranced in just listening to the perfect way my words fit that tune. Right now they're listening to me, my lyric reads like a poem. It surely stands on its own, it makes me proud to hear that music. It's a total expression of me. To be more specific, this place is terrific.